Hello, my dear students. I hope you all are doing well and all are safe and enjoying your quarantine days. I am Miss Manjushri Pawar and I'll be teaching you subject pharmaceutical packaging. And in today's session, we will have a very short introduction of pharmaceutical packaging and also we will cover few of the topics from chapter 1. So the subject pharmaceutical packaging. First, let us see why we need to study this subject. Let us understand the importance of this subject. In pharmaceutical industry, there are numerous departments. Like there is production department, there is R&D, there is analytical department, and there is QA, QC. Likewise, packaging is also one of the very important department in pharmaceutical industry, which does all the work related to packaging of products, including its documentation. So what happens once the manufacturing of drug is done, once the drugs are manufactured, they are stored properly such that its stability is not affected, then they are subjected to packaging operations. So the drugs, or you can say medicines, they are in direct contact with the packages, like strip package, blister package, then caps, closures, ampoules, vials, etc. So the medicines are in direct contact with the packages, and if the packaging is not proper or if the packages are of poor quality, what will happen? It will affect the products that are stored in it. So the people who are involved in packaging operations should be well trained and they should have all the knowledge associated with it. If not, then the product quality will be affected, which will ultimately affect patients' lives. Like for example, oral solid dosage form tablets are to be packed. So decisions regarding the type of packaging material plays a very critical role. Like if any tablet is light sensitive, so it has to be stored in ambered colored strip or ambered colored or dark colored blister or bottle, because in presence of light, some drugs start degrading and they will form new compound which will harm the patients. But if by mistake the person packed it in a transparent bottle, then what will happen? Even if the tablets manufactured are of best quality, it will get degrade because of inappropriate selection of packaging material. Because in transparent bottles, the light may pass through it and the light may penetrate into the product, leading to the formation of new compound which will affect the patient's life. So the selection of packaging material plays a very important and critical role, and the physical and chemical properties of drug substance may get degraded if the packaging materials are not selected appropriately. So apart from the knowledge of manufacturing, understanding packaging operations, understanding all the properties, functions, then advantages, disadvantages, etc. of the packaging material is also very important. And in this subject, we are going to study about all these packaging materials in depth. There are only two chapters in this packaging subject. In chapter 1, you will have an introduction about packaging. Like you will be studying what is packaging, why it is required, what are the types of packaging materials, then functions of packaging, properties of ideal package, then how the packaging is carried out in pharmaceutical industry, etc. In second chapter, you will study different types of packaging materials like glass, plastic, metals, flexible packaging, then strips, blisters, caps, closures, ancillary materials in packaging, then labeling, etc. So we will study everything about these packaging materials, like its types, then advantages, disadvantages, properties, quality control tests, etc. So now let us start with chapter 1, that is introduction to pharmaceutical packaging. What is packaging? Packaging is the process by which pharmaceuticals are suitably packed so that they should retain their therapeutic effectiveness from time of packaging till they are consumed. So when the patient takes the medicine should be able to give its therapeutic effect or pharmacological effect, and for that purpose, appropriate packing is a must. So packaging should be done in such a way that the medicine retains its therapeutic effect when it is consumed by the patient. Like I gave you an example of light sensitive products, the packing of light sensitive injectables should be packed in ambered colored vials or ampoules. If not, then the product will not be able to give its therapeutic effect. Packaging is also defined as the art, science, and technology of enclosing or protecting products for distribution, storage, sale, and use. So after the drugs are manufactured, they are subjected to packaging operations, and the type and design of the package is like whether to select the strip package or blister package or bottles, vials, and the selection of caps and closures. So and the selection of packaging procedure or technology, all these things depend on the type of formulation. For example, tablets are packed in strips or blisters, then injectables are stored and packed in vials. Then for liquid orals, bottles are preferred. And the cold products having the temperature range of 2 to 8 degrees Celsius should be packed in 2 to 8 degrees Celsius storage room temperature only. If the packing is done at room temperature, then its quality, identity, efficacy will be affected. The packages are then packed in a big shippers, then through transportation via vehicle, air or sea, these shippers are further distributed for sale and use. So packaging is an art, science and technology of enclosing products for further distribution, storage, sale and use. Ideal requirements of packaging. The quality of packaging of pharmaceutical products plays a very important role, and the packaging should protect the product against all adverse external influences that can alter the properties of the product. Example, moisture, light, oxygen, and temperature variations. So packaging should be done in such a way that it protects the drug from harmful environmental conditions of moisture, light, oxygen, temperature. If the water vapors or moisture gets into the package, then that may lead to hydrolysis of product. So water resistant packing is preferred for moisture sensitive products, and if the temperature changes very high, it will cause the degradation of the product, and at a very low temperature, the product will get crystallized or the product may get freeze, affecting the quality of the product. Then from air, the gases like oxygen may get diffused into the product, and that will lead to oxidation of product. So various physical, chemical and microbiological degradation may take place if the packing is not proper. And for a product to remain within a particular chemical, microbiological, therapeutical, physical and toxicological specification, the packing should be done in that way. Then the packing should protect the product against biological contamination. So the presence of living organisms in the environment like bacteria, viruses, fungi may affect the quality of the product, causing the biological contamination. So packing should be done in that way, taking care of this. Like several packaging materials like paper and board attract the growth of fungi if it comes in contact with the moisture. Then during transportation or storage, the dust may get accumulated inside the product, and that may lead to biological contamination of the product. And all these things can be avoided by doing proper wrapping of the packages. So the packaging should be done in such a way that it protects the product against biological contamination. Then the packaging should protect the product against physical damages. So now we all know that the products are transported via vehicle, and if the packages are not properly stored in vehicle, like if there is too much stacking of packages one over another, then that may lead to physical damage of products. Then during transport, if the driving is very rough, or if there is vibration of vehicle during transport, and also if the products are not stored properly inside the vehicle, then there are chances of falling products and causing damage to it. Then also there will be misplace of labels, and if emulsions and tablets are stored in vehicle, and if the vehicle and if there is too much of vibration of vehicle, and that if the driving is very rough, what will happen, the emulsion that is stored may get cracked, and the tablets may get break, and the closures may get loose, causing the leakage of the product. So there will be destruction of everything. And for this purpose, packaging should be up to the mark as required to avoid all these physical damages. Then packaging should be non-toxic. Like if plastic is used as a packaging material, then it should not be a toxic to the product. Certain chemicals in plastic are harmful, and these toxic chemicals can enter the product through packaging. So selection of appropriate type of packaging material is very important, and the packaging material should be non-toxic to the product. Then packaging should carry the correct information and identification of the product. So the information like type of product, name of the product, then strength, quality, strength, quantity, route of administration, then manufacturing date, expiry date, storage condition, then manufacturing license number, then warning signs like keep out of reach of children, etc. So all this information, all the required information should be present on the packages. All the correct information should be present on the packages, and the product should be easily identifiable. Then the packaging should be adaptable to commonly employed high speed packaging equipments. So the packing equipment should not cause any wear and tear of the product. The equipment should not cause any damage to the product or any damage to the packing material while the packaging operations are going on, and the equipment should be well adaptable to the product and packaging material.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, students, for your kind attention, and I hope you must have got at least a little bit idea about packaging. And if you have any doubts, then please ask me in the comment section. Thank you.